Brothers and sisters, greetings. 我们今天是营会的第四堂 ，This is the fourth session in our camp meeting.
Thank you.
我们看希伯来书十一章，从第一节开始。
We'll read Hebrews chapter 11 from verse 1.
信就是所望之事的实底，是未见之事的确据。
Now faith is the assurance of things hoped for, the conviction of things not seen.
各位，什么是信？
What is faith?
如果我们中国人，钱穆先生说中国人是心的宗教，心脏的心。
There is a Chinese saying that it relates to the heart.
我们喜欢讲心。
We like to talk about the heart.
其实原文没有心字。
There is no
信。
In faith, there is no heart.
就是信 ，faith， 不是 faith heart。我们中文是 faith heart， 信心。
In Chinese, there is the word heart in this phrase, but in there is no such thing.
我们说眼见为凭，我们说百闻不如一见，我们说见证人。
We like to say, speak of, witnessing and experiencing as to see.
Yeah, 你眼见为凭，百闻不如一见，见证人。那么看见是很重要的。
To see is very important.
使徒的资格之一就是亲眼看见耶稣。
One of the qualifications for the apostles was to personally have seen Jesus.
使徒行传一章二十节、二十一节、二十二节。
Acts chapter 1 verses 20, 21, and 22.
他们必须从耶稣基督在他们中间的时候，就是从施洗约翰开始，一直到主离开使徒被接上升的日子为止，必须从那常与我们作伴的人中立一位与我们同作耶稣复活的见证。
So one of the men who have accompanied us during all the time that the Lord Jesus went in and out among us, beginning from the baptism of John until the day when he was taken up from us, one of these men must become with us a witness to his resurrection.
使徒选，他们要选一个人接替犹大。
The apostles were choosing someone to replace Judas.
这个人的条件是需要看完全本圣经，会背四福音书吗？
The requirements for this person must be that they've read the entire Bible and can memorize and recite the four Gospels.
当然那个时候还没有圣经。
Of course, the Bible wasn't written then.
他的条件就是需要看见过耶稣，从施洗约翰开始到他复活升天，他都看到过。
The qualifications was that they must have seen Jesus from the baptism of John.Through his ascension.
在哥林多前书十五章第三节。
From First Corinthians chapter 15 verse 3.
我当日所领受又传给你们的，就是基督照圣经说为我们的罪死了，埋葬了，又照圣经说第三天复活了。
For I was delivered to you as of first importance what I also received that the Lord that Christ died for our sins in accordance with the Scriptures.
第三天复活了。
And that he was buried and he was raised on the third day.
十五章第五节，并且显给基法看，
and、
然后显给十二个使徒看。
And then verse 5, and that he appeared to Cephas and to the 12.
后来一时显给五百个弟兄看。
Then he appeared to more than 500 brothers at one time.
以后显给雅各看。
And then to James.
最后也显给我看。
And then to me as well.
也就是我们主耶稣的复活是有人看到的。
In other words, the resurrection of our Lord Jesus was witnessed by people.
各位姐妹，对不起，希望你不要生气。
Sisters, I'm sorry, I hope you're not angry.
看到耶稣复活的，除了这些人以外，还有谁啊？
Who else saw Jesus' resurrection apart from these people?
谁先看到耶稣复活啊?
Who first saw Jesus?
谁把耶稣复活的消息传开?
Who brought the news of Jesus' resurrection?
都是女性。
It was the women.
可是这里保罗都不提他们。
But here Paul doesn't talk about them.
保罗的做法是跟当时罗马人的做法一样。
Paul's decision was the same as how the Romans acted.
对不起，在罗马时候，女人的见证不算数。
In the Roman times, women's testimony did not count.
所以当保罗说耶稣复活被人看见，他不提女性。
And so when Paul talks about Jesus' resurrection being witnessed, he doesn't mention any of the women.
姐妹不要觉得圣经从一开始就在歧视女性。
So sisters, don't think that the Bible is discriminating against women.
我一开始就讲，女性在各方面都非常优秀，很多时候是优于男性的。
I've said many times that women are excellent in many things and more excellent than men in many.
我的翻译似乎很 hesitate。
Seem to be hesitating.
没有关系，你们优秀，所以神要你们特别隐藏，因为太优秀了。
Because you are excellent, God wants to hide, wants to hide you.
所以连你们看，连女性看到耶稣复活的事，他都不记载。
So even when women witnessed the resurrection of Jesus, he didn't record it.
不过我说提这个事，就是我们的信仰是建立在可靠的见证人上面。
But I mention this because our faith is built upon reliable testimony.
而这个可靠的见证，其实就是我们的五官。
And this reliable testimony is, in practice, our senses.
Sense, yeah. 在约翰一书第一章讲的更直接了。
In 1 John, it is more clear.
论到起初原有的生命之道，就是我们所听见、所看见、亲眼看过、亲手摸过的。
Regarding the word that we've seen with our eyes, which we looked upon and have touched with our hands.
他甚至说我们摸过的。
It even says that we've touched it with our hands.
我们的信仰是建立在圣灵保守下五官的那些资讯。
Our faith is built upon, under the guidance of the Holy Spirit, our senses.
结果是圣经这本书。
And the result is this Bible.
圣经里面记载关于耶稣的事，关于神的事情，有讲到看。
In the Bible, regarding Jesus, regarding God, and having to do with seeing,
就是门徒是看到了关于耶稣的事。
Or in other words, the apostles saw things to do with Jesus.
门徒也听到耶稣的事。
And they heard things regarding Jesus.
门徒也看到人摸耶稣的事。
And they saw when people touched Jesus.
你记得有一个妇人，有一个品性不良的妇人，用手摸耶稣的脚。
Remember a woman, a wicked woman who touched the feet of Jesus.
我们也看到圣经讲耶稣脚被人记录下来。
And we also see that the Bible records what Jesus says.
然后我们写下来，有人写下来。
And someone writes it down.
我们也看到圣经里面也有讲到闻鼻子的功用。
And we also see the Bible recording smell, or the work of our noses.
记得玛利亚把香膏打碎了，玉瓶打碎了，屋里就满了膏的香气。
Remember when Mary broke the vial of perfume, the room was filled with the perfume.
圣经又记载耶稣的沉睡。
The Bible also records Jesus sleeping deeply.
甚至耶稣的沉睡跟约拿的沉睡很像。
Even for Jesus' sleep to be very similarly described as Jonah's.
约拿在悖逆上帝当中，他睡得很好。
Jonah slept very well when he rebelled against God.
耶稣在服侍上帝很辛苦之后，睡得也很沉。
Jesus, while after serving very faithfully and very hard, he slept very well.
总之，我们所信的是有人在圣灵的保守之下，把我们五官所经历的写下来。
In any case, what we believe is, after the guidance of the Holy Spirit, what people have sensed with their senses was written down.
这是我们所信的。
This is what we believe.
这是我们相信，这是我们信赖的东西。
This is what we trust.
我们希伯来书第一十一章第三节，我们因着信。
Hebrews chapter 11 verse 3, by faith,
我们因着信可以把它翻译成我们在信心当中。
By faith can also be said in faith.
我比较喜欢 in faith.
I prefer
因着在信心当中。
I prefer in faith.
因为因着信好像把信当作一个武器，在信心当中是我们的一个状况。
By faith seems like faith is a weapon.But in faith is a condition.
我们在信心当中，我们就知道很多的事。
In faith, we know these things.
他说我们因着信就知道诸世界是借着神的话造成的。
But in faith, we understand that the universe was created by the word of God.
各位，你知道有些人在讨论，神的创造有证据的。
Everyone, you know that when some people talk about the creation, they have evidence.
有清楚的证据。
There's clear evidence.
我们根据这些证据，我们知道世界是神，是有创造者，或者说有一个 intelligent designer.
Based on this evidence, we can say that there is a creator or that there is an intelligent designer of the world.
我们根据一些证据，我们知道上帝造了世界。
Based on some evidence, we know that God created the world.
不过这个努力是可佩服的。不过在圣经里讲，我们知道世界是上帝造的，是因着信，可以说还不是直接是因着证据。
The effort there is admirable, but biblically speaking, we can say that it is by faith or in faith that we know God has created the world and not through evidence.
希伯来书十一章都在讲在信心中的伟人。
Chapter 11 of Hebrews talks about men of faith.
先说我们所有的基督徒相信神造的世界，这已经把我们放在信心伟人之中了。
First, saying that all Christians we believe that God created the universe and that places us among the men of faith.
然后讲到个别的人，十一章第四节。亚伯因着信，或者说在信心中献祭与神，比该隐献的更美。
In verse 4, it's talking about specific people, by faith or in faith, Abel offered to God a more acceptable sacrifice than Cain.
这件事情我要说一下。
I want to talk about this a little.
各位，亚伯和该隐是亚当夏娃的儿子。
Abel and Cain are sons of Adam.
该隐是长子。
Cain was the older.
亚伯是次子。
Abel was the younger.
该隐是农夫，亚伯是牧羊的。
Cain was a farmer, Abel was a shepherd.
该隐是工作非常辛苦的人。
Cain worked very hard.
那个时候的土地比今天还要贫瘠。
The soil was poorer than today.
你知道亚当夏娃离开了伊甸园以后，他们来到的世界是一个非常是一个被咒诅的世界，土地非常贫瘠，只有荆棘和蒺藜。
Know that when Adam and Eve left the Garden of Eden and came out to the world, this was a cursed world that had very poor soil full of only thorns.
我们今天的世界土地没有再被咒诅。
Our world today, the soil is not cursed.
这是因为挪亚出了方舟以后献祭，神说我不再咒诅地了。
Because when after the flood, Noah exited the ark and offered to God, and God said, "I no longer curse the earth."
总之，该隐在的世界是非常辛苦的。
So the world that Cain existed in was very difficult.
他要汗流满面才能糊口。
He needed to sweat profusely in order to make a living.
我想不止汗流满面，也是泪流满眼、血流满手，因为荆棘很多。
And not only sweating it profusely, but also bleeding because of all the thorns.
他很苦。
He had a hard life.
我只能推测。
I can only assume.
他想他应该要献祭给上帝，使上帝对他好一点。
That he thought he needed to offer things to God in order for God to be better to him.
该隐是第一个献祭的人。
Cain was the first to make an offering.
你并没有看到上帝要他献祭。
You don't see God asking him to make an offering.
他是第一个献祭的人。
He was the first to make an offering.
第一个献祭给上帝的人也是第一个杀人的凶手。
The first to make a sacrifice to God was also the first murderer.
从一个角度来讲，我们看该隐也很可怜啊。
From some perspective, we can see that Cain was pitiful.
他在一个咒诅的世界。
In a cursed world,
他要汗流满面。
He needed to work extremely hard.
泪流满脸，血流满手，才能糊口。
With tears and blood to make a living.
我只能这样推测，他在这种艰难的情形下，他希望奉献给上帝，能够改善他的状况。
I can only assume that he offered to God to make a sacrifice to change his condition.
各位，我们华人应该很了解这种心态嘛。
Everyone, us as Chinese people, we should understand this kind of thought process.
如果你的老板让你很辛苦，你解决的办法就是送点红包给他嘛。
If your boss makes you work very hard, then the way to solve that is to give him a red envelope.
那么该隐很辛苦，送点吃的给上帝是很自然的想法。
Cain worked very hard, and so he very naturally thought to give some food to God.
他觉得上帝是很小气、很凶狠、很需要东西的人，于是他就奉献了，献祭了。
He thought God was very stern, very harsh, and jealous, and so he gave a gift to God.
各位，你奉献给上帝，不管是金钱或侍奉，要甘心乐意啊。
Everyone, when you give to God, whether it's money or service, it needs to be willing.
你的奉献必须是甘心乐意，也就是是有信心的。
Your offering must be willing, and in other words, with faith.
如果再讲清楚一点。你对神有信心，就是你认为你所侍奉的这位神是一个仁慈的、良善的、全能的，反正是一个最好的神。
To be even more clear, you trust that the God you serve is one who is kind, good, and all in other words, all good.
你奉献钱给他，不是希望他收了这个钱，收了这个东西。他会对你好一点，他是很大方的，不是因为你给他东西他对你好一点，是因为你知道他对你好，所以你给他东西。
You give him money not because in order to make him treat you better. You know that he's generous and that it's because he is generous and has given you a lot that you want to offer.
亚伯在信心中献祭给神。
In faith, Abel offered to God.
圣经说神喜悦悦纳他的礼物。
The Bible says God was pleased with his gifts.
有人说这个背景是耶和华喜欢畜牧文化，不喜欢农业文化。
And some people say that the context for this is God prefers a shepherding society versus agricultural society.
这不全是一个笑话，因为迦南地都是务农的，务农的容易去拜巴利，畜牧的虽然是牛仔，但是 神喜悦他们。
This is not entirely a joke because the Canaanites, or the land of Canaan, was full of an agricultural society, and it was easy for them to worship Baal. But even though the shepherds, they were all cowboys, God preferred them.
当然这是一个笑话了。
That's a joke.
那么亚伯是因为不是因为他献祭的东西是上帝喜悦的肉。该隐献祭的是素祭，神吃肉不吃素的，所以神就不喜欢该隐的祭，不是这样的，因为神根本不要吃这些东西。
And it's also not because what Abel offered was meat, and what Cain offered was vegetarian, and God doesn't eat vegetarian. God doesn't need to eat, and so that's not the issue.
希伯来书讲得很清楚，亚伯奉献的时候是因着信在奉献的。我们可以说，该隐就不是因着信在奉献的，所以神喜悦亚伯的，不喜悦该隐的。
The book of Hebrews is very clear that Abel offered gifts to God in faith, and so we can say that Abel offered in faith and Cain didn't.
在信心中的奉献，神喜悦，结果是怎么样呢
？A offering made in faith, what is the result?
结果是该隐把亚伯杀了。
The result is Cain killed Abel.
不但把弟弟杀掉了
，Not only did he kill his younger brother,
他还觉得自己很倒霉，很委屈。
He felt wronged.
他说。我被你赶，被上帝处罚，我会流离在各地，看到我的人都要杀我。
And he said to God, I've been driven out by you, and as I wander the earth, anyone that sees me will kill me.
各位，你大概听过这样的问题吧？那个时候，这个世界上有几个人？亚当、夏娃、该隐、亚伯以及他们的妻子，就六个人。六个人。亚伯死掉就五个人，亚伯自己不算就四个人。亚伯碰到四个人，这四个人会要他的命吗？爸爸妈妈和老婆。
You've probably heard this question, but how many people on earth were there at the time? There was Adam, Eve, Cain, Abel, and their wives. And Abel's dead. Cain doesn't count. So the four people that Cain can run into, will they actually want to kill him?
所以人家说《创世纪》记载的不对啊，或者《创世纪》还有很多东西没有写在这里。我承认很多东西没有写在这里，但是那个时候世界上人的确不多。
And you can say that, that maybe this is wrong, or that there is a lot of things not recorded in Genesis. I admit there are things not recorded in Genesis, but at the time there weren't many people.
该隐杀了人。
Cain murdered someone.
该隐犯了罪。
He sinned.
犯罪最坏的结果就是我们心不安。
The worst outcome of sin is that we are not at peace.
他心非常的不安。不过这也不是我们要讲的重点。我们要讲的重点是亚伯的信，亚伯因信献的祭得主的喜悦，但他的遭遇并不好。
And so he was very not at peace, but that's not what we're focused on. Abel offered in faith, and yet his outcome was not good.
我们仍然是很欢喜快乐的在信心中侍奉上帝。
We very joyously serve God in faith.
我们不但在信心中服侍上帝。
Not only do we serve God in faith.
而且上帝因为我们有信心，他很喜悦。
But also because we have faith, God is pleased.
我们熟悉这句话，十一章第六节：人非有信就不能得神的喜悦。因为到神面前来的人必须信有神，且信他赏赐那寻求他的人。
We're very familiar with this phrase, and without faith, verse 6, and without faith it is impossible to please him. For whoever would draw near to God must believe that he exists, and that he will reward those who seek him.
挪亚也是在信心当中，也是因着信。
Noah also acted in faith, and because of faith.
圣经上十一章第七节说神蒙神指示他未见的事，动了敬畏的心。
And verse 7, it says, being warned by God concerning events as yet unseen in reverent fear.
他预备了一只方舟，使他全家得救。
He constructed an ark for the saving of his household.
请问神指示他未见的事，未见的事是指什么？
Let me ask you, concerning the events yet unseen, what events yet unseen are there?
可能是指着洪水。
It could refer to the flood.
也可能是指着方舟。
It could refer to the ark.
比较可能是洪水。
More likely it's the flood.
因为那个未见的事情，就是还没发生过的事，可能发生的。是洪水使他害怕，方舟应该没有使他害怕。
Of the things that are yet to happen, it's more likely that the flood would cause fear rather than the ark.
各位，这了不起的信心啊！
This requires amazing faith.
挪亚和他家里的人
，Noah and his household.
也是只有几个人。
And it's still just a few people.
挪亚和他太太两个。
Noah and his wife.
然后。三个儿子
and three sons,
三个媳妇
three wives,
这就八个人
that's eight people.
所以听说方舟我们中国人的船就是八口之家
and so we have the saying, this
船 the ship is
the ship is eight person、
okay.
yeah.
那么当他造这个方舟的时候
when he constructed the ark,
我不知道你们去过那个 Ark 博物馆没有
I don't know if you've been to an Ark museum.
那么那是一个很大的东西
It's a very large thing.
挪亚很聪明的
Noah's very smart.
把他全家八个人把这艘 方舟建起来
His household of eight built this entire Ark.
他不仅是建了方舟而且圣经上讲传义道的挪亚
Not only did he construct the ark, the Bible records him as Noah who spreads the way of righteousness.
他传道，他建方舟。
So he preached and he built the ark.
他跟他的邻舍讲。
He told his neighbors.
会有一场大雨临到。
There's going to be a great storm.
会把整个地面都淹掉。
And the earth will be covered.
各位，那个时候没有下雨。
At the time, it didn't rain.
挪亚说会下大雨。
And Noah said it's going to rain.
我们要预备一只方舟逃那个雨。
We needed to prepare this ark to escape the rain.
挪亚传义到多久，建方舟就多久。
However long he preached the way of righteousness, he built the ark for.
最少几十年吧。
It's a few decades at least.
我看到挪亚的生平，我很得到安慰。
And when I think of Noah's life story, I am very comforted.
因为我在台湾传道多年，很难有一两个信主。
Because when I preached in Taiwan for many years, very few believed.
挪亚传了几十年，一个都没有人信。
Noah preached for decades, and not a single one believed.
他建方舟，他传道。我猜他所建方舟的地方，跟今天的方舟博物馆一样。每个礼拜六下午都有好多游览车来看。
I imagine that wherever he built the ark, as in the same way as the ark museum today, there every Saturday there are tour buses showing up to take.
我们这里有个疯子。
We have a crazy person here.
他很聪明。
He's very smart.
他建了一个方舟。
He built this ark.
他说会有大雨降下来。
He said that there's going to be a great storm.
哈哈哈哈！真是奇笨的笨蛋。
This is such a foolish person.
圣经上说，神用各样的事让那个世代的人有警醒，要警醒。
The Bible tells us that God uses all kinds of ways for the people of the time to be alert.
包括让挪亚传义道。
Including using Noah to preach the way of righteousness.
还有在洪水前的七天。
And also before the flood for 7 days.
有一个非常神奇的事情。
There's a very miraculous thing that happened.
就是全世界的动物。
It was that all the animals of the earth.
七对七对，一对一对的走进方舟。
By sevens and by pairs, they walked into the ark.
所有的畜生。
All of the cattle.
没有聪明智慧，但是他们都进了方舟。
The beasts, without any wisdom.Or knowledge, they entered the ark.
可是有聪明智慧听到挪亚传道的人，没有一个人进去。
But the people with knowledge and wisdom, they heard Noah's preaching and yet did not go into the ark.
我坐飞机的时候听到现在舱门机舱门关闭，我都想到挪亚的方舟。
Every time I take a plane and I hear them closing the door, I think of Noah's ark.
挪亚的方舟门是上帝关了。
In Noah's ark, God closed the doors.
那个门关了，就没有人能开了。
When the door closed, no one can open it.
然后就下大雨了。
And then it rained.
我看过一个手表的广告。
I watched a watch advertisement.
很多人在大雨当中跑到那个方舟前面，使劲的敲门呢。
A lot of people ran in the rain to the ark and was banging on the doors.
太晚了，他们进不去。
It's too late, they couldn't get in.
那个手表广告就是 timing is important.
And the watch ad said time is important.
挪亚因着信
Noah, because of faith,
建了一只方舟
He created the ark,
使全家得救，也定了那个世代的罪
He saved his, for the saving of his household and also condemned the world.
亚伯拉罕因着信蒙召的时候遵命出去。
Abraham by faith obeyed when he was called to go out.
信心里面有一部分一定是不知道。
There is always an element of unknown within faith.
也有一定有知道的成分。
And there is always an element of known.
他知道是神呼召他。
He knew that it was God calling him.
他不知道那个地方是什么样子的。
He didn't know what.That place was like.
各位，你知道亚伯拉罕离开的地方是米索波大米那个地方，两河流域。
You know that Abraham, the place he left was Mesopotamia.
那个地方是文明发开始的地方。
The places where the rivers meet is the beginning, the cradle of civilization.
那是最肥沃的地方。
It was the richest area.
那是文明最发达的地方。
It was where civilization was most flourishing.
他来到迦南地，那是一个贫瘠的地方。
And the place he got to Canaan was a place of poverty.
不但那是一个贫瘠的地方，那个地方住着迦南人。
Not only was it poor, the people that dwelt there were Canaanites.
他根本得不到那个地方。
He couldn't have received the land.
神应许亚伯拉罕到一个地方。
God promised Abraham to get to a place.
斯提凡说，亚伯拉罕到死没有立足之地，连两只脚的地方都没有。
Stephen says, even till his death, Abraham did not have a place to even stand on.
他是带着信心死的。
He died still in faith.
因着信。亚伯拉罕和他的儿子以撒都在应许之地做客。十一章第九节。
Verse 9, by faith he went to live in the land of promise, in a foreign land, living in their tents.
就是上帝的话没有实现。
God's words had not been fulfilled.
希伯来书十一章第十节说，因他等候那座有根基的城，有吗？
And as it says in Hebrews 10:10, and that he's waiting for the city with foundation. Did that happen?
我在创世纪里只看到亚伯拉罕等候一块地。
I only see that in Genesis, Abraham is waiting for the land.
亚伯拉罕等候他的儿子。
He's waiting for a son.
希伯来书告诉我们一件在旧约没提过的事：亚伯拉罕等候有根基的城。
The Hebrews here tells us that something else the Bible didn't tell us previously. He was waiting for a city that had foundation.
什么叫做有根基的城？
So what is a city that has foundations?
通常圣经讲到城市跟乡村不一样的地方，就是城市有墙。
What the Bible says, city, it's different from a village. It's a city has walls.
这里强调这个城是有根基的。是基础稳固的。
Here it emphasizes that the city has foundations and that its foundations are secure.
你知道我们要去的地方吗？
Do you know where we are going to go?
那是一个堂，天堂。
It is a hall, heaven.
那是一个国，天国。
It's a kingdom, a heavenly kingdom.
那是一个家，神的家。
It's a house. It's the house of God.
那是一座城。
It's a city.
奥古斯丁说那个城是叫做 City of God， 神的城，上帝之城。
Augustine said it's the city of God.
在圣经里面也有讲到神有城。
In the Bible, it also describes that God has a city.
奥古斯丁的话很有名，他说。有两种人造成了两座城。
Augustine also describes a very famous situation. There are two people who have built cities.
两种人造成了两座城，这两种人是由两种心造成的。
Two types of people have built two cities, and they are built with two kinds of hearts.
一种人他的心是爱上帝的，一种人他的心是爱世界的。
One is their hearts love God, and the other their hearts love the world.
我们是在上帝的城里生活吗？我们是爱上帝的吗？
Do we live in the city of God? Do we love God?
那么，如果我们是爱上帝的，我们被上帝经营建造，我们就是这座城里的一份子。
If we love God, if we're managed and built up by God, then we are a member of the city.
你们大概也会唱一首诗歌吧。
I imagine you know the song.
Holy City.
Holy City.
圣城。
Holy City.
圣城耶路撒冷。
The Holy City, Jerusalem.
我们永远要想到，我们做神的儿女是内心属他，那是最重要的。
We need to know as children of God that our hearts belong to Him, and that's most important.
如果只有外表，那么 Holy City 就变成 Devil City 了，圣城就变成邪恶之城了。
If it's only external, then the Holy City, the City of God, becomes the City of the Devil. The Holy City becomes the City of Evil.
可能各位，我不晓得你对耶路撒冷，现在我们在新闻里看到耶路撒冷。你有什么感觉？
Everyone, I don't know how you feel about when we hear about Jerusalem in the news.
我觉得人类所有的城市，包括西安，包括北京，包括莫斯科，包括罗马。
I imagine all the cities of the world, including Xi'an, Beijing, Moscow, Rome.
没有一座城像耶路撒冷一样这么赚人的眼泪。
No city.Causes people's tears as much as Jerusalem.
恐怕也没有一座城像耶路撒冷一样流了那么多的血。
And there is probably no other city like Jerusalem that has shed so much blood.
耶路撒冷啊，耶路撒冷！耶稣看到耶路撒冷就哭了。
Jerusalem, Jerusalem! Jesus saw Jerusalem and he cried.
我多次要聚集你们，你们不肯。
I wanted to gather you for so long, and yet you were unwilling.
他们的心没有向着神。
Their hearts were not towards God.
各位，你的心是不是向着神
？Everyone, are your hearts towards God?
你的心向着神，你的心是不是向着神的城
？If your hearts are facing towards God, they're facing towards God's city.
如果你的心向着神的城
，And if your hearts are facing towards God's city,
你的心是向着你现在前后左右的弟兄姐妹。
Your hearts are towards those brothers and sisters around you.
当我们有这样心的时候，希伯来书十一章十二节
，verse 12 of chapter 11.
所以从一个仿佛已死的人就生出子孙，如同天上的星那样众多，海边的沙那样无数。
Therefore, from one man, and him as good as dead, were born descendants, as many as the stars of heaven, and as many as the innumerable grains of sand by the seashore.
神应许亚伯拉罕，他的子孙会像天上的星、海边的沙那么多。
God promised Abraham that his descendants will be as numerous as the stars in the sky and as the sands by the seashore.
可是当他九十九岁的时候，撒拉八十九岁的时候，他们还是没有孩子。
And yet, when he was 99 and his wife Sarah was 89, they still did not have a child.
亚伯拉罕和使女生了一个儿子，但是神说那个不算。
Abraham had a son with a servant girl, and God said that didn't count.
在创世纪十七章，耶和华对亚伯拉罕说，明年这个时候，撒拉会生一个儿子。
In Genesis chapter 17, God told Abraham, this time next year, Sarah will give birth to a son.
你知道亚伯拉罕听到有什么反应吗？
Do you know what Abraham, how Abraham reacted when he heard this?
圣经讲，我们中文和合本的翻译是，亚伯拉罕听见就暗笑。
And the Bible says, when Abraham heard this, he secretly laughed.
其实原文没有暗笑。
In the original language, there was no secrets.
或者有一个地方是喜笑，也没有喜字。
And he didn't mock.
在圣经里面，亚伯拉罕听到他明年会有儿子，他就笑了。
When Abraham heard that he was going to have a son in the next year, he laughed.
似乎他是苦笑，没有什么信心。
And it seemed to be a laugh of despair without faith.
因为他说了，100岁的人还能得孩子吗？
Because he said, how can someone who is 100 have a child?
所以看起来他没有什么信心。
So it seemed like he didn't have faith.
但是他做了一件事情。
But he did something.
神说明年这个时候你会有孩子。
God said, this time next year you will have a son.
那么现在我要求，我跟你立约，你全家的男丁都要受割礼。
I will make a covenant with you that all the males of your household need to be circumcised.
圣经上说，正当那一天。
And the Bible says that day.
神下了一个命令，要他全家的男丁受割礼。
God gave them the command that all the men of his household needed to be circumcised.
但是神并没有说你要什么时候全家受割礼。
And yet God didn't say when they all needed to be circumcised.
各位，神应许亚伯拉罕有孩子。
God promised Abraham a child.
撒拉是等了这个应许以后25年才得孩子。
Sarah waited 25 years after this promise to receive a child.
神让我们的信心之父等了25年。
God had our father of faith, Abraham, 25 years.
亚伯拉罕没有叫上帝等一天。
Abraham didn't have God wait even a single day.
神说要受割礼，没有说今天就受，但是亚伯拉罕今天就受，当天就受，没有叫神等一天，真是有信心。
Even though God didn't say that they needed all to be circumcised within the day, Abraham and his household were circumcised that day. He didn't have God wait even a single day.
神给亚伯拉罕应许有没有实现？
Did the promise to Abraham from God, did it become fulfilled?
神应许亚伯拉罕两个东西。
God promised Abraham a couple of things.
一个是地，
one is land.
另外一个是人，
the other is people.
神说我会把这个地给你。
God said, I will give you this land.
圣经上说，亚伯拉罕到死，连立足之地，一双鞋子的地方都没有。
And God, the Bible tells us that even at his death, Abraham didn't have a place even to stand.
亚伯拉罕还是信。
And yet Abraham still believed.
至于说人呢，你会得到很多人。
And as to people,
像天上一样多。
You will receive many descendants, as many as the stars in the sky.
各位亚伯拉罕的子孙，的确像天上星那么多，孤星泪呀，只有一颗啊。
And there were truly as many stars in the sky as he had descendants, and it was a single star.
我们看过十一章第十三节，这些人都是存着信心死的，并没有得着所应许的。
We see in verse 13, these all died in faith, not having received the things promised.
哇，这叫我们受很大打击，有信心的人没有得着所应许的。
This is traumatizing to us. The people that had faith didn't receive the things that were promised.
更重要的是，他们继续信下去。
And more importantly, they continue to believe.
更重要的是，他们虽然还没有得到， 他们好像从遥远的地方看到了一样。
Even though they haven't received, they have seen from afar.
各位，这正是我们现在的状况，我们比他们好多了，但是也有一点相似的地方。
This is similar to our current condition. We are better in some ways than them, but there are also similarities.
我们有圣灵，我们有主耶稣基督，在旧约的时候都还没有清楚地得到。
We have the Holy Spirit, we have the, Jesus. In the Old Testament, they have not clearly received these.
各位，我们的难处我在前几天已经讲过。
Everyone, I've already talked about this previously regarding our difficulty.
就是我们得到了，但是比起那些佛教徒无神论，哎，他们可能更多哎。
We have received, and yet compared against Buddhists, atheists, whoever, we may have received more.
不过我要说的就是，他们得到的可能在金钱、在地位上、在今生，可能的确比我们多，不一定。
What I'm saying is they may have received more in money, in position, in prestige in this world, maybe, but maybe not.
各位，我们基督徒有什么东西？今生此时此刻我们就有，而是那些无神论异教徒没有的。
But what do we Christians have today in this life right now that no one else has?
你心中的平安和喜乐，那不能被夺去的平安和喜乐，那世界不能给的平安和喜乐，你今生就可以得到。
The peace and joy that's within your life that cannot be separated from you, that cannot be taken, and you have that now and in this life.
求主帮助我们。
May the Lord help us.
你要有信心。
You need to have faith.
我不能保证你会得到多少。
I can't assure you that you will receive however much.
物质上，我不能保证你会得到多少。
I can't ensure that you will receive anything materially.
但是心灵有人不能给也不能夺走的平安和喜乐。
But in your heart, you will have joy and peace that cannot be given or taken away by anyone else.
我的时间好像已经到了，对不对？
还没有，
还有25分钟哈。好，感谢主。那我要有一点信心。
Thank the Lord. I needed some faith.
总是很担心。
Was worried about time.
好，我们继续看下去。
So let's continue.
希伯来书第十一章第十五节。
Hebrews chapter 11 verse 15.
他们若想念所离开的家乡，还有可以回去的机会。
If they had been thinking of that land from which they had gone out, they would have the opportunity to return.
他们却羡慕一个更美的家乡，就是在天上的。
But as it is, they desired a better country, that is a heavenly one.
我们有信心，并不是说我们就是呆子。
We have faith, that doesn't mean we're foolish.
有人说信心是 blind faith, 盲目的信心，我们不盲目。
Some people say faith is blind faith, we're not blind.
信心不是跟理智冲突的。
Faith is not contradictory to reason.
我们需要用理性，我们甚至需要用思想，甚至需要用想象力。
We need to use logic. We need to use reason and even imagination.
当亚伯拉罕听到上帝要他献儿子的时候
，When Abraham heard God telling him to sacrifice his son，
要献以撒的时候
，To sacrifice Isaac，
我们通常觉得困难就是伦理上、道德上的。
We always think that the difficulty here is morality, is ethics.
怎么可以叫一个父亲杀儿子呢？
How can you tell a son, a father to kill a son?
这太难了。
That's extremely difficult.
这个是难，不过对亚伯拉罕这不是最难的。
That is hard, but it's not the hardest thing for Abraham.
说真的，亚伯拉罕下得了这个狠心。
To be frank, Abraham was able to take the step.
亚伯拉罕能够听上帝的话，离开他的本地本族父家。
Abraham was able to obey God's word to leave the land of his father.
亚伯拉罕也可以听，也会听神的话，把他的儿子杀掉。
And he obeyed God's command to kill his son.
事实上，我们看到他已经拿刀要刺他的儿子，如果不是天使拦阻的话，他就会杀死他。
we see that he was already with a knife in his hand, ready to strike his son. And if not for the intervention of angels, he would have killed his son.
亚伯拉罕杀以撒困难在哪里？
What was the difficulty for Abraham to kill Isaac?
亚伯拉罕是有信心的。
Abraham had faith.
有信心就听神的话。
He had faith and so he obeyed God.
但是现在他听到两句话是矛盾的，都是神的话。
But he heard two things from God, both from God that were contradictory.
一句话是
One is
从以撒生的才算你的儿子。
Only those born of Isaac shall your offspring be named.
从以撒生的才是你的后裔。希伯来书十一章第十八节。
Chapter 11:18, through Isaac shall your offspring be named.
这是一句话。
That is one.
另外一句话。
And the other.
把以撒杀了献给我。
Sacrifice Isaac to me.
如果把以撒杀了，以撒就不会有儿子了。
If you kill Isaac, then he's not going to have offspring.
如果你要以撒有儿子，就不能杀他。
And if you want Isaac to have children, then you can't kill him.
亚伯拉罕愿意听神的话，但神的话矛盾的时候怎么办？
But what happens when Abraham is willing to obey God, but God's words were contradictory?
各位，神的话不会矛盾的，我们得用脑筋去想怎么办。
God's words will not be contradictory. We need to think what could it be?
亚伯拉罕决心就把以撒杀了。
Abraham was determined to kill Isaac.
他有一个想象力。
He had imagination.
因为这件事没有发生过。
Because this has never happened before.
所以是他想象的。
And so he's imagining it.
他以为神能叫人从死里复活。
He imagined that God was able to raise him from the dead.
神要他杀以撒。
God wanted him to kill Isaac.
他愿意杀。
And he was willing to kill him.
但以撒死了。
But when Isaac died,
以撒怎么可能有子孙呢？
How can he have children?
亚伯拉罕想，
Abraham imagined，
他恐怕是绞尽脑汁想，
and he probably thought very hard about this。
我杀了他，神能叫他复活。
If I kill him, God can resurrect him from the dead。
各位，神并没有用叫以撒复活的办法来解决这个问题。
Everyone, God didn't use the method of resurrecting from the dead in order to solve this problem。
神就拦阻了亚伯拉罕杀以撒了。
God intervened in the process of Abraham killing Isaac.
那么我们看到这里，信心不但不是违反理性的，信心可能还要动用想象力。
We see here that not only does faith not contradict with reason, but it also sometimes requires imagination.
二十节，以撒因着信就指着将来的事给雅各、以扫祝福。
By faith, verse 20,Isaac invoked future blessings on Jacob and Esau.
我们来看看这件事情。
Let's look at this.
以撒因着信。
By faith, Isaac.
以撒在信心当中祝福以扫和雅各。
In faith, Isaac blessed Jacob and Esau.
那么是不是以撒在跪着祷告禁食三天中之后给两个儿子祝福呢？
Did Isaac fast for 3 days, knelt in prayer, and then bless his sons?
以撒因着信，这是怎么样因着信呢？
So what kind of a faith was this when it says Isaac in faith?
各位，以撒这个时候137岁。
At this time, Isaac was 137.
他看不见了。
He was blind.
他以为他要死了。
He thought he was going to die.
其实他又活了43年。
And yet he's lived another 43 years.
如果你以为你今天就要死了，明天就要死了。
If you thought you were going to die today or tomorrow.
又活了43年，这是很大的福气啊。
And then you live another 43 years, that's a great blessing.
但对以撒来讲，这是一件糊涂事。他才137岁，还有43年好活，他以为他快要死了。
But for Isaac, this was a foolish act. He thought he was going to die, and yet he lived another 43 years.
创世纪二十七章第一节说，以撒年老，眼睛昏花，不能看见，就叫了他大儿子以扫来说， 我老了不知道哪天死，现在我要祝福你。
Genesis chapter 27 verse 1, Isaac was old and his eyes were dim so that he could not see. He called Esau his older son and said to him, I'm old and I will bless you.
所以以撒不是在信心中祝福，我们看到是第一个以撒在糊涂当中祝福。
What we see is that Esau, Isaac was not blessing in faith, he was blessing in confusion.
然后那个时候要祝福。
And so when he wanted to bless,
他要 吃一顿好吃的才祝福，他不能吃的我们在早餐来祝福。
He wanted to have a good meal, not the breakfast we just had, before he blessed.
这真的很好笑，他跟他儿子说，你去打猎。打到做成美味给我吃，然后我吃了龙心大悦就祝福你。
And he said to his son, "Go hunt and make me a good meal, and then when I'm satisfied, I will bless you."
这是在信心中的祝福吗
？Is this a blessing in faith?
然后他老婆听见这个话了，利百加听见了。
And his wife Rebecca heard this.
利百加喜欢小儿子，以撒喜欢大儿子。
Rebecca preferred the younger son, Isaac preferred the elder son.
我们在圣经里很多人说基督化的家庭，各位我实在找不到一家是基督化的。
And people say that there is a Christ-like family in the Bible, and everyone, I really can't find such a family in the Bible.
包括耶稣的家庭。
Even the family of Jesus.
他的兄弟也不信他。
His brothers didn't believe him.
不过我们感谢主，因为他们跟我们有一样的性情。他们蒙福，我们也可以蒙福。
But thank the Lord, they have the same character as us, and because they can be blessed, we can be blessed.
这个家只有四个人呢。
This family had only four people.
以撒和利百加还有两个儿子。
Isaac, Rebecca, and the two sons.
双胞胎。
Twins.
妈妈跟小儿子讲：“你老爸要祝福你哥哥了。”
The mom said to her younger son.Your father is going to bless your older siblings.
我不要他被祝福，我要你被祝福。
I don't want him to be blessed. I want you to be blessed.
现在你爸看不见了。
Your father's blind.
先去拿两只羊，我把它煮成你爸爸喜欢的味道，然后你拿给你爸爸吃，他祝福你。
Go kill a couple of sheep. I will make it into something that your father likes to eat. Bring it to him, and he'll bless you.
你妈妈叫你。跟他联合骗你爸爸
your mom,
你的回应是什么
If your mom tells you to work with her to trick your father, what do you do?
你会说妈不要骗吧不要骗爸爸吧我们还是不要做这个事
Would you say, mom, let's not do this deceitful thing?
雅各不是
Jacob wasn't like that
雅各的个性是有力就抓抓了就不放
Jacob's character was that he took every opportunity and every advantage.
他跟妈妈说：“被抓到了怎么办
？”He said, "What if he catches me?"
被抓到可能性很高哦。我们兄弟虽然双胞胎，但是有一些不一样的地方。
And pretty likely to be caught because even though we're twins, there are some differences between us.
我们的声音不一样。
We sound different.
我们的皮肤不一样。
Our skins are different.
雅各全身是东方人，光滑的。
Jacob is like an Oriental person. He's smooth.
以扫全身的毛像星星一样，真的像星星一样。
Esau is described as almost ape-like, full of very hairy.
我爸听到声音不对，百闻不如一见，百见不如一摸，一摸就摸出不对了，他就咒诅我了。那怎么可以？
If my dad realizes something is wrong based on my voice and then he reaches out and touches me to make sure, what happens then? And he curses me.
各位 so far 你听到的是什么地方有信心啊
Everyone, where do you see faith in any of this?
这里面都有欺骗啊有自私啊偏心啊
This is deceit, selfishness, and
信心在哪里啊
Where is the faith?
还有嘞
And then?
如果我爸发现我是冒牌的，他咒诅我，他不会祝福我。他妈妈就说：“咒诅归我，祝福给你。”
And then he says, "If my dad realizes I'm the wrong person and he curses me instead of blessing me, what happens? And the mom says, I will take the curse, you take the blessing.
如果你是雅各，你会说什么呢
？If you're Jacob, what would you say?
哦，妈妈，你为我受咒诅，不好意思，不要不要不要，我们就不要骗了。
And,
但他没有关系，妈妈受咒诅好啊。
And Jacob, did he say, "Oh, mom, you don't have to take the curse for me. That's too much. Let's not do this." He said, "Okay, mom, you'll take the curse. Great."
各位请注意啊、哦，一定要记得新约在讲，他们是因着信。我在问信心在哪里，这里都通通是尔虞我诈。
Remember when the Bible says, when the New Testament says they all did this by faith, where is the faith?
好，雅各装成哥哥进去了。
And so Jacob then pretends to be his brother and goes in.
老爸，请吃。
The father eat.
他爸说你是谁
？His dad said, "Who are you?"
我是你的大儿子啊，你赶快吃了祝福我。你怎么你怎么会找这么快的就找到了呢？他说：“哎呀，因为耶和华让我有好运气，一出门就碰到羊，就打着了。”
He said, "I'm Esau, your firstborn." And then Isaac said, "Oh, how did you get back so quick?" And he says, "Oh, because the Lord has granted me success, and I went outside and I immediately saw these sheep."
雅各不仅是自私。
Not only is Jacob selfish,
不顾母亲的安危自私
he didn't care about his mom. Or,
他愿意骗他爸爸得到祝福
He's willing to deceive his father for blessing.
他还用耶和华的名字来骗
He also deceived Isaac with the name of the Lord.
信心在哪里
Where is the faith?
那么以撒真的就来摸一下哈。
And so Isaac really did reach out and touch.
然后说，嗯，这皮肤是哥哥的皮肤，你真的是我的儿子以扫吗？他说我是啊，赶快祝福啊。
He said he reached out and said, "Oh, this is really it feels like Esau." And he said, "Are you really Esau?" And Jacob said, "Yeah, I am. Hurry up and bless me."
那么，爸爸。什么时候去祝福了他
？When did the father bless him？
圣经上说他闻到雅各衣服上的香气。各位，所以姐妹们，那Chanel number five是很重要的。
And he smelled. It says he smelled of his garments. And sisters, Chanel number five, that perfume is important.
他就祝福他。
And so he blessed him.
他祝福他。的子孙非常的富裕，得到很多的土地。
He blessed him that his descendants will be very prosperous and will have a lot of land.
其中有一句话。
And part of it.
创世纪二十七章二十九节。
In chapter 27, verse 29 of Genesis.
愿你做你弟兄的主，你母亲的儿子向你跪拜。
May be lord over your brothers and may your mother's sons bow down to you.
我是雅各听了我可能都会哭出来爸爸你这么讨厌我、啊、
And if I were Jacob I would probably cry and say Dad how do you hate me so much
你这么喜欢哥哥这么讨厌我要我的子孙向哥哥的子孙跪拜啊
you love my brother and you hate me so much that you want my descendants to bow to my brothers
不过他忍住
But he held his tongue
他要得到祝福他得到了
He wanted to receive the blessing, and he got it.
他祝福完了出门，前脚出门，后脚他哥哥就进来了。
And as he was leaving, just as he was leaving, his brother came back.
带着野味给他爸爸说：“爸爸，请你吃，给我祝福。”
And he also brought delicious food and said, "Father, let's eat and bless me."
以撒对他说：“你是谁？”
And Isaac said to him, "Who are you?"
我是你长子以扫啊。
He said, "I'm your firstborn, Esau."
以撒发现他被骗了。
Isaac realized he's tricked.
他被骗了，应该是大大的愤怒啊。
And he should be very furious.
创世纪二十七章三十三节不是说他大大的愤怒，是他大大的战惊，他吓死了。
And verse 33 said he wasn't furious, he trembled very violently. He was terrified.
为什么
？Why？
因为以撒和他的妻子很早就知道，在他妻子怀孕的时候就知道，神是要大的服侍小的。
Because even early on, even when Rebecca was pregnant, Isaac knew that God wanted the older to serve the younger.
以撒非常柔和，愿意听神的话。
Isaac was very gentle and was willing to listen to God's words.
但这件事上他不愿意。
But here he wasn't willing.
他像很多东方的父亲一样，喜欢长子，他要长子得到祝福，做头。
And like many Oriental fathers, he preferred his eldest son and wanted his eldest son to be the leader.
所以他眼睛一看不见，他就要确定他能祝福给大儿子。
So as soon as he couldn't see, he wanted to make sure he can bless his eldest son.
所以他一直想要做的一件事情就是保护大儿子，不要神对小儿子的祝福实现。
And so one thing he's always wanted to do was to protect his eldest son and not have God's blessing towards the younger come true.
现在他发现他做的一切的努力都不能够违反上帝的旨意。
And now he realizes all of his work could not overcome the will of God.
他再摸再确定还是给小儿子得到祝福了。
Whatever he did to touch, to confirm, he still ended up giving the blessing to the younger.
他还可以做一件事。
And there's one thing for him to do.
他可以把小儿子叫来。
He can have the youngest son come over.
我收回刚才对你一切的祝福。
I retract all of my blessing.
我咒诅你，你这个骗父亲的人。
I curse you, you deceiver.
然后对老大说，老，不要哭，不要哭，不要哭，爸爸祝福你。
And then say to the elder, "Don't cry, Daddy will bless you."
以撒没有。
Isaac didn't do that.
当他的大儿子苦苦哀求、放声痛哭、父啊，求你祝福我的时候，以撒的确也祝福了他。但是最重要的那句话，你将来要你的子孙要服侍你弟兄弟的子孙，他没有收回，他没有收回。
And when Esau was crying very bitterly before his father, saying, "Bless me, bless me." Isaac did bless him, but the one thing that your descendants will serve your brother's descendants, that he did not retract.
你必定侍奉你的兄弟。
He said, "You will serve your brother."
各位，这叫信心。
This is faith.
以撒在贪吃当中，在偏心当中，祝福了他的大儿子和小儿子。
Isaac, even in his gluttony, even in his preferential treatment for one, he blessed the younger.
而且他祝福了小的的时候，他可以收回的，他没有收回，因为我想他发现一件事。再怎么努力，不能逃过上帝的旨意，所以我顺服吧。所以希伯来书作者说，以撒是在信心中祝福的。
And so even when he could retract his blessing, he didn't, because I imagine he realized there's no way I can overcome God's will. And so the author of Hebrews records it as in faith he blessed.
我们看希伯来书十一章二十三节。
Let's look at Hebrews chapter 11, verse 23.
摩西生下来，他的父母见他是个俊美的孩子，就因着信把他藏了三个月，并不怕亡命。
By faith, Moses, when he was born, was hidden for 3 months by his parents because they saw that the child was beautiful and they were not afraid of the king's edict.
哎呀，信心不是不凭眼见吗？
Is faith not based on our experience?
Based on sight.
Sight.
这里说摩西很俊美，所以他父母就把他藏起来了。
Here it says Moses was beautiful, and so his parents hid him.
那意思就是摩西如果长得像我一样，他父母就不会藏他了。
Which is to say, if Moses looked like me, his parents wouldn't have hid him.
我们不管怎么样，反正他的俊美激发了他父母的信心。
So regardless, his beauty created or brought up the faith of his parents.
不过那个信心只有三个月。
But that faith that lasted only 3 months.
在《使徒行传》第七章，斯蒂凡讲这件事的时候，是说摩西被丢弃的时候。
Acts, chapter 7, when Stephen talked about this, he describes when Moses was discarded.
各位，不管你做了多漂亮的一个小方舟，
no matter what kind of a beautiful ark you've created,
把小孩子放在里面，
and you placed your child in there,
然后放在尼罗河里，
placed it in the Nile,
让它随波逐流下去，
and so that he could be carried by the current,
还是要他的命啊。
He's still gonna die.
我不知道有什么父母做这件事可以做得很安心。
I don't know what parents can do this with a peaceful heart.
说起来，摩西被拯救，多半是埃及人在拯救他，多半是他的同胞在丢弃他。
Talking about Moses being rescued.It was more the people of Egypt rescuing him and his own people rejecting him.
这一点我们都没有注意，其实约瑟也是这样。
And we didn't realize this, but Joseph was the same way.
他哥哥、他兄弟把他丢弃了。
His brothers discarded him.
埃及人提升了他。
The Egyptians raised him.
甚至连大卫也有点这种经验。
David was also similar.
他后来，他当然是被他的以色列王逼迫，然后他曾经逃到腓力士境界得到保护。
He was persecuted by the king of Israel, and he escaped to the Philistines and was protected there.
摩西被埃及法老女儿捡起来的时候很动人。
It's very touching when Moses was rescued by the daughter of Pharaoh.
他放在那个篮子里面。那个法老的女儿在洗澡的时候看到了，就叫使女拿过来。
He was in this basket, and when the daughter, the Pharaoh's daughter, was bathing, she saw it and had it brought to her.
摩西的姐姐远远站着。
Moses' sister stood far off.
看到那个箱子被捡起来了。
And saw that the basket was picked up.
看到她打开箱子了。
He saw her opening the basket.
他恐怕在祷告，摩西啊，露出你最甜美的笑容，嘿嘿。
And she was probably praying, Moses, show her your most beautiful smile.
他祷告没有蒙垂听，孩子哭了。
And her prayer wasn't answered. The child cried.
但是那个法老的女儿爱他，可怜他，就救了他。
But Pharaoh's daughter loved him and pitied him and so rescued him.
法老的女儿救了他。
Pharaoh's daughter rescued him.
摩西后来是被他的同胞推开。
Moses was discarded by his people.
那个被推开一定让他心很痛。
And that must have been very difficult for him.
当他后来逃到米甸的旷野的时候
，And so when he was in the wilderness of Media，
他在逃的时候，他还是有正义感，他救了那些祭司的女儿。
And he had the sense of righteousness. He saved the daughter of the priest.
这些女孩子回到家里，爸爸说：“你们今天怎么回来这么早啊
？”And when these women went home, and their father asked them, "Why did you come home so soon?"
他们说，因为有一个埃及人救了我们。
They said, "Because an Egyptian saved us."
我说这个话就是神固然拣选了以色列人，也拣选了我们，但是在一般恩典，在一般的这个恩典，今世的恩典里面，我们也可以看到埃及人、腓力士人都有他正面的地方。
We see that, I say this because we see even though we've been saved, God saves us, the Egyptians, the Philistines, they have their positive points.
我们今天就只能讲到这个地方，这个法老的女儿救了摩西，摩西做了他的儿子。我们今天在这个世上 固然我们以教会为家，可是这个世界不是我们的家，但这个世界也是上帝叫我们在其中做光做盐的地方。
We can only leave it here today. Pharaoh's daughter raised Moses, and he became her son. And even though we are in a church, the church is the house of God. The world is not our home, and yet God wants us to be in the world as light and salt.
愿神赐福大家。
May God bless everyone.
我们做一个祷告。
Let's pray.
天父上帝，我们感谢你的恩典，求主带领我们在这次的退休会里能够有真实的领受，有真实的得着。求主帮助，奉耶稣的名祷告，阿门。好，谢谢大家，下面。